Okay, we'll have one or two more questions towards the end. Let me move on now to our next minister and bring in Alexei Pavlenko, the Minister of Agrarian Policy. And there are a number of issues that get talked about over and over again at these kind of panels, have been for years. Deregulation, we've already done, tackling corruption. And I guess in your area, the key issue is land reform and land ownership. Can you just tell us what your plans are for that area, and particularly with regard to what might be possible for foreigners and foreign ownership of land?
Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to sit here, like last year and the year before last year, and for many years I was part of you. And for me it's like a big challenge to think, understand the role that currently I'm sitting here, because probably 1 year, 2 years, you, some of you also be sitting here and, yeah, answering the questions. I try to be, let's say, up to the point without saying so many, like, political things. Agri-ministry becoming very important, you know, so we have number one in terms of export, it's agribusiness. We're also the only industry which showed the growth comparing year to year. And let's also be open, we're the only industry which shows profitability so far. Together with that, we do understand that one of the main role for us also to show to the business is how attractive we are and say what kind of plans we have. This year we had quite good yield. We had 63.8 million of production. It's also, you know, that we lost about 1.5 million of tons in the Lugansk, Donetsk, and in occupied Crimea. And despite of that, we really showed the growth comparing year to year, and also now coming to the record figures in terms of our export activities. Because once again, coming back that despite of the situation problems at the east, we control the major ports, which is Odessa, Nikolaev, Yuzhny Ilyichovsk, and with that it's actually our export hub, and we also continue to be very important worldwide. Ukraine number one in terms of sunflower seeds production, number one in terms of sunflower oil, number three in terms of grain, number three in terms of corn. So we are within top five real food basket worldwide. And we're becoming also a very dangerous competitor. So also to be open, because so many our friends, they now also our competitor, and we should also understand that. We're actually working with Asia, we're actually working with, you know, with Egypt, we're starting to open new markets. In one of the major role of our agri-ministry to create all proper conditions and to necessary conditions for our business to be actually working on the external markets. One of the major projects, you know, we have signed an association agreement with European Union in 2014, and we're moving very fast in terms of regulation and synchronization. Many things started from food safety up to regulatory acts, parliament acts. This year we have to pass 169 different regulation and laws in order to open for this market, European market for dairy, for pigs market, pigs meat and wheel meat. We've been able to open European market for chicken, for example, for chicken eggs. And we also, you know, one of the issues raised, and we just started with Ministry of Economy, and we already started discussing with our European partners that we are ready as a country to discuss quotas. We're ready to discuss quotas increase, and with that we'll start not easy process, but we already see some kind of support from our European partners, and I hope that by the end of the year we can also talk about increasing quotas. In addition to that, we already have so many discussions with our investors, partners, foreign partners. We know that we had discussions with companies like Class that we're ready to support them to open production. We also had discussion with KWS about also open production of the seeds businesses, which is we think also could be some kind of blue ocean in terms of producing, is extra margin activity. And for that we have one of the best climate, one of the best land, and one of the best worldwide conditions where to grow the seeds. We have huge potential within agribusiness. Once again, this year 63.8, and we put the target of 100 million tons of production. And it's really feasible and achievable in from 3 to 4 years perspective. Together with the proper investments, together with correct approach to the logistical issue, we started with World Bank, thanks to the World Bank, the process of analyzing and involving experts in terms of irrigation activity to the south of Ukraine. from analyzing the framework of the legal status up to investment point. We also now have 8 different projects about reforms with European Union commissions, and next week we'll announce publicly what we're doing, some kind of results, starting from land reform, rural development, small, medium-sized business. Another issue, it's for food safety. That's why we are very careful about the guillotine, because, you know, there were some examples in Georgia when they did a guillotine and they stopped all the export activities for several months. And we together working actually with Ministry of Economics for that, because we will not kill the cow, let's say. So, because the cow should give the milk and not the meat. Yeah, it's, we also have such an understanding that we should be take careful approach of not killing the cow, let's say. And together with that, we're actually working on the regulations issues. We have joint teams with, once again, our European Partners Commission, one of the best experts worldwide involved. And also we have several platforms, NGOs from ReformEA, so many volunteers, big tax and legal companies who actually pushing and proceeding from regulation activities up to parliament. And together also with that, I started the project with USAID in terms of actually restructuring of the ministry, starting from the competence matrix, head hiring process and the function analysis. It's also thanks to our American partners, we also do that. We also now involved many big names, you know, like Pedersen Partners, Talent Advisors, as well as Hardwell, also Deloitte and Touche, and we do together with Ministry of Infrastructure and other ministries in terms of headhunting. It's completely, let's say, breaking approach, because we openly, transparently show that all the positions we involving, introducing people from also, let's say, this, I see also saw some so many faces who also applied to the state enterprises as well to the ministry, so you're also welcome to join with that. We also, thanks to IFC, IFC is also very actively involved in process of helping us to make the market of Ukraine as very attractive, and IFC is very, you know, was very active in terms of agri investments. One of the biggest also invested together with EBRD, and so many people are involved within also the legislative acts and the regulation. Another issue would be with the corruption, so I saw also how popular is this issue. I'd like to say that also we're changing the approach from starting the nomination committee, so people see here part of the nomination committee, which will pass 61 enterprises, which now also Ivar, Andrew, and Natalka are doing. So all of them would be passing nomination committee, and after only after that would be proposed to go to the state CEOs, and they should be transparent, they should be open, and we should also with that to break the corruption. We also first in the history introducing the audits. We started the audit of DPZKU grain company with BDO. We're starting the project with all big four companies in terms of Ukrspirt, which one of the major corruption scheme. And what we decided, we do the full due deal, and all the companies would take some part, starting from receivables, fraud investigation, payables, commitments, liabilities. And the same would issue we do with Agrarian Fund. For DPZKU, also question about corruption fight. I'm so happy that we have changed in the prosecution, general prosecutor, which currently very helpful to us and also involved a lot in the such kind of fight with the corruption. And we gave the cases only in grain company for $120 million of direct fraud with direct names of the companies in the last 9 months. Stated correctly that actually it was very straightforward when the ships of grain has been sent abroad to BVI, LTDs, and never ever came back in terms of money. And with that, we're involving all the bodies and saying that publicly that people should be found and prosecuted. Otherwise, we had to show the cases that actually the, we're also not tolerating any kind of fraud. The same issue with Ukrspirt, more than 400 million hryvnias has been found in terms of taxes not paid, 172 million hryvnias of corruption in terms of purchases, stealing the alcohol, blah, blah, blah. So it's another case. Now we're also opening issues with Agrarian Fund. We've been able to change management recent weeks there. And also we found so many interesting issues from the banks which are under liquidation. Millions of hryvnias there, I don't know how they appeared. 2.2 million hryvnias, sorry, in Brock Business Bank, which is also currently we have the problem, and having the old budget for agrarian ministry for 400 million hryvnias, believe me, it's quite a huge amount of money. This year is very tough for agrarian business because we have zero subsidies, zero dotations, no for milk, no for pigs, no for nothing, no for gardens. And we also now had issue with VAT. It was VAT cut for all, for producers as well, for exporters. And we do understand the tough budget because we saw, Natalka told, we so-called have military budget with 68 billion hryvnias of budget, which we should give now to our military campaign, which is up to 5% of GDP. And Natalka also told that overall our estimate that we lost approximately from 18 to 20% of our economy in the East. We do understand that, but together with that, we also like to show to the business that still agrarian sector is very, very much popular, profitable, and interesting. Just remember, let's say last year when the price of entering to the agrarian land was up to $1,000 to the hectare. At this moment, you can go and buy it, let's say, entrance price is very low. You also probably will have the question about MRIA issue and how we're involved, because I do remember these questions last time. So for me, it's also honor to say that we also, as agrarian ministry, take active role in that. We also, I see also guys from Rothschild here, and we're taking very active role there. And we not only communicating, we organized several big meetings about preserving the company itself and our position as a government. We would like the company to be preserved and the creditors should be, let's say, take and receive their money back. And what we can do, we can organize the meetings with GUTAS, we're organizing ministry meetings with Ministry of Police, and also the Interpol issue. Also issue with the land. With the land, we're also asking to block the land registration and trying to help as much as possible to the creditors. And I hope that there will, some solution will be found and we'll have, let's say, good case example how we, together, government and PRI, have been able to help such a situation. And for that, we do a lot. We together with our deputies and other ministries. About land reform, coming back, thank you for the question. We'd like to introduce 7 years lease as soon as possible because currently, you know, we have 2, 3, 5 years and you cannot do proper investment as being investors here with a payback of 2, 3 years in the agribusiness, it coming from elevator to the machinery, and minimum 7 years, but in reality up to 20 could be one of the solution of blocking land reform. Land reform means that, you know, the issue of sales of land still is very political. It's blocked up to 2017, but long rent could solve the issue, I think, for such a time. We also will focus a lot on deregulation of the land, on the bureaucracy, with the registration, re-registration, because it's one of the main issues for the investors, because it's really very much untransparent. Another project was for Cadastrium, it's a database for land. It's fulfilled properly only up to 5%. We will also, as a ministry, will take an active role in this. Despite the fact that land is not the issue, land is under the other ministry, Ministry of Regional Development, but we will take the active role in that. We also take the active role in sanitarian, phytosanitarian, despite the fact it's not also under our control, but it's also one of the issues which is one of the basic for food safety. About veterinars, we have up to 40,000 veterinars in Ukraine, 40,000 veterinars controlling the issue of food safety, and we'll also be leading one the reform also in that sector, trying to show once again openly, transparently, that this business is interesting in our case and our, let's say, the role here of the ministers to give opportunity for the business to work in this country and to help business to work and earn money in this country. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed for a very comprehensive overview. And of course, there will be a whole separate panel tomorrow, I think, on agriculture as well.